Good morning, Booth Warriors. This is Grayson.
And Brianna.
Today is Friday, January 31st, 2020. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence while we reflect on today's activities and focus on demonstrating our best behavior. Please be seated.
Are you interested in being a cheerleader at Booth Middle School? If so, there'll be a parent information meeting on February 4th from 5:30 to 6:30 in the Media Center. Please contact Coach Wolf, Coach Lowry, or Coach Gatlin if you have any questions.
Attention all 7th and 8th graders interested on being on the track team this spring. There will be a short informational meeting on Tuesday, February 4th at 8 a.m. in the gym. Please make plans to attend.
We will be celebrating World Read Aloud Day on February 4th. Teachers and students will be reading their favorite books and classes throughout the building. There will be a book trivia session in the cafeteria too. Sounds like it's going to be a good day.
There will be clubs today. Please check with your homeroom teacher for the changes in the schedule.
Today is National Hot Chocolate Day. Hot chocolate was created 2,000 years ago by the Mayans. Europe helped popularize the beverage after it was introduced by Mexico in the New World. Later in the early 1800s, Caparisus Van Houten Sr. created a process to separate the cocoa solids from the butter, which was a new way to make hot chocolate. Today we enjoy hot chocolate by mixing up some cocoa, sugar, and milk. So today let's all enjoy a nice cup of hot cocoa.
All students are advised to use the tunnel if going to McDonald's or Chick-fil-A after school. For your safety, please do not cross Highway 54. Please reserve the privilege of gathering at Chick-fil-A. We expect you to be on your best behavior.
Remember, a warrior is always responsible, respectful, and ready to learn.
And now for the character lesson. Happy Hot Chocolate Day!
Good morning, Booth Warriors. This is Savvy
and Aaron
with a few words of wisdom. American actor Edward James Olmos has visited many young people in schools, hospitals, libraries, and juvenile detention centers. His message? Keep trying until you get what you want out of life. Why? Because sometimes it takes a lot of determination to achieve our goals. It can mean working hard and not giving up in the face of fear and failure.
Today, remember the message of Edward James Olmos and the words of another great American actor, Mickey Rooney. You always pass failure on the way to success, so don't let failure stop you. Instead, let failure be an opportunity to do better the next time, an opportunity to try harder and learn from your mistakes.
For something to think about, this is Savvy
and Aaron.
Make it a great day or not, the choice is always yours.
Good morning, Booth Warriors. This is CJ bringing you the weather for Friday, January 31st, 2020. The high for today will be 46 with a low of 39 with a 70% chance of precipitation. There will not be recess today. This weekend, you can expect nice weather. Have a great day, Warriors.
Good morning, Booth Warriors. This is Joy bringing you the lunch menu for Friday, January 31st, 2020. Your choice of entrees today will be stuffed crust cheese pizza, stuffed crust pepperoni pizza, fish nuggets with hush puppies, Buffalo chicken tenders with roll, and jammer pack. For sides, you have whole kernel corn, veggie dipper cup, coleslaw, diced pears, and a mini Rice Krispie treat. For your deli choice, you have grab and go plate of a chicken tender wrap plate, and as always, choice of milk. Have a great day, Warriors.
Welcome back to Sports Talk. I'm your host, Kevin.
And Hayden.
And today's subject will be about the Super Bowl between the Kansas City Chiefs and San Francisco 49ers.
We will soon get to that, but first we're going to talk about the San Francisco 49ers. They beat the Green Bay Packers in the NFC Championship, which was not a surprise to many.
The 49ers played an amazing first half with help from Jimmy Garoppolo and Raheem Mostert, and they put the Packers in a hole so deep that they couldn't get out.
Next, we'll be talking about the Kansas City Chiefs. They have not been to the Super Bowl since 1970. That is 50 years. They outplayed the Titans and stopped Derrick Henry.
Now, let's talk about the Chiefs versus 49ers.
I think the 49ers are going to win. Jimmy Garoppolo is a proven quarterback. He is 7-0 when passing over 250 yards. Raheem Mostert has had back-to-back 180-yard games.
I disagree, and I think the Kansas City Chiefs won. They mainly have one of the 25th best rush defenses in the league, but that is heavily compensated by the best pass defense in the league versus wide receivers. And in my opinion, they have one of the top three best quarterbacks in the league.
You have a pretty good point and all, but let's see what our fellow Warriors feel about this game.
Thank you for coming on Sports Talk, Uche. What is your opinion on the Super Bowl?
I think the 49ers are going to win. They have a really good offense. Jimmy Garoppolo is a really good player. Raheem Mostert is playing good. And although the Chiefs have a really good offense and defense, I think that the 49ers are going to win.
Yeah, I mean, I do believe that the Chiefs may have a chance, but in my book, I really feel like the 49ers will win because they have a great offense. Then they have a great defense with Nick Bosa and Richard Sherman. That's a pretty much unstoppable team right there.
We'll see. Thank you for watching Sports Talk. I'm Kevin.
And Hayden.
See you next time on Sports Talk.
Because of your dishonesty, you're fired. You're fired. You're fired.